Now I will discuss about the conversion related to the aromatic carboxylic acid. Identify A, B, C and D. These are the following questions. I will first do the first question. This is your benzoic acid and it is subjected to reaction with Br2 in the presence of FeBr3. This is your said to be halogenation and COOH group is a metadirecting group. This position is said to be your para position. These two positions are said to be ortho and the remaining two this position are said to be meta position. Since it is a metadirecting group, so one bromine atom will attach at the meta position of the carboxylic group and on this product. This is your said to be metabromo benzoic acid. This is your said to be metabromo benzoic acid and it is considered as the product A. Now it is subjected to reaction with SOCl2. Then chlorine atom will attach here and OH will be removed and it will form the product this. This is the product obtained and it is considered as the product B. Now this B product will react with the NH3. NH3 is written as HNH2. Your hydrogen atom will react with the chlorine atom, form a byproduct that is your HCl, and NH2 will attach here and form this product. This is your said to be C. Next, I will solve the second question. This is your benzoic acid and it is subjected to reaction with the NH3. This is your acid, this is your base. When acid base reaction takes place, then salt will be produced. That is your ammonium benzoate. And it is considered as the product A. Now it is subjected to heating. Heating means there is a loss of water molecule. For water molecule, we need two hydrogen from this and one oxygen atom. That is a minus H2. As a result, the product is your CONH2, that is your benzamide. And it is considered as the B product. Again it is subjected to reaction with P2O5. P2O5 is a dehydrating reagent. As a result from this product, water is lost. For water molecule we need two hydrogen and one oxygen. As a result we can write C triple bond N. After loss of oxygen and two hydrogen, here three bond is necessary, here also three bond is necessary including this bond. So we can form a triple bond. That is your cyanobenzene product and it is considered as the product C. Again cyanobenzene subjected to reduction with a lithium aluminium hydride. That means lithium aluminium hydride supply the nascent oxygen. Now the product C is subjected to reduction. This is your cyanobenzene. Now I will break a pi bond here and give one hydrogen to this carbon atom and another hydrogen is to the nitrogen atom. That means the product is what? CH double bond NH It is unstable again. It undergoes reduction. So I will take another pi bond. It has H. That means we can write CH2NH2. That is your product D. So we can write here. This is your D product. Benzoic acid undergoes reaction with NH3. A product is formed, that is your ammonia benzoate. Again, it is subjected to heating, there is a loss of water molecule takes place, and benzamide is formed, which is subjected to reaction with P2O5. P2O5 is a dehydrating reagent. It loses the water molecule. As a result, cyanobenzene is formed. This cyanobenzene undergoes reduction in the presence of lithium aluminum hydride. The product D is formed. Next, I will solve the question number 3. This is your question number 3. Your benzene is given. Now benzene is subjected to reaction with the CH3Cl in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. It undergoes Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction and toluene is formed. This is said to be product A. Now the product A is subjected to oxidation with the alkaline KMnO4. Then you also need heating. Then benzoic acid is formed. Now benzoic acid is subjected to reaction with the TCl5. Then OH will be removed and Cl will be attached here. This is said to benzoyl chloride and it is considered as the product, that is your C, and this is your considered as the product B. Now benzoyl chloride is subjected to Rosenbaum reduction, that is your palladium barium sulfate and xylene sulfur. Then benzaldehyde is formed. This is your said to be product D. Now I will solve the question number 4. This is your said to be benzoic acid. It is subjected to reaction with concentrated HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4. That means it undergoes nitration. So NO2 group will be attached at the meta position because COX is a meta directing group. So we can write this, and this is the product A. Now it is subjected to reaction with the SOCl2. Then OH will be removed and chlorine will be attached. This is the B product. This is your A and this is your B. Now I will do the question number 5. This is your said to be benzene. It is subjected to reaction with the CH3Cl anhydrous AlCl3. That is your said to be Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So your alkyl benzene is formed. That is said to be toluene and it is considered as the product A. Now it is subjected to halogenation in the presence of sunlight. So here one hydrogen atom will combine one chlorine atom and give a byproduct, that is your HCl, and this is your product B. Now the product B is subjected to reaction with the alkaline KCl. The cyanide group will attach here and the product is your this and it is considered the product C. Now it is subjected to hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis H2H+. Here the CN group will be removed and COOH group will be attached. That is your CH2COOH and this is your considered as the product D. Now I will do the question number 6. This is your benzene. It is subjected to halogenation, Br2, FeBr3. Then halobenzene is formed. This is your said to be product A. And it is subjected to reaction with magnesium in the presence of dry ether. Then Grignard's reagent is formed. That means your this product and that is your considered as B. Now Grignard's reagent is subjected to reaction with the CO2 followed by hydrolysis. Then what will be the product C will be formed. Now look at this. This is your phenyl magnesium bromide and it is subjected to reaction with the carbon dioxide. This part will attach here and the pi bond will break and ad hoc is formed. This is your ad hoc and it is subjected to acid hydrolysis. That means H. This is your OH. So the product is your C6H5, bond C double bond O, bond OH, that is your benzoic acid. So here we can write the product C is your benzoic acid. That is your C6H5COH. Next, the benzoic acid is subjected to reaction with the CH3OH in the presence of H+. This is your said to be C. Then an ester is formed, that is your C6H5COOCH3. This is your considered as product D. Now I will do the question number 7. Benzene is subjected to reaction with CH3CL. Anhydrous AlCl3, then Friedel-Crafts alkylation express, that is also said to be toluene and it is considered as the product A. And this product A is subjected to reaction with the CrO2Cl2 water. This is also said to be ethyl reaction. As a result, benzaldehyde is formed. This benzaldehyde undergoes oxidation, then benzoic acid is formed. This is your said to be B, this is your said to be C. Now the C product is subjected to reaction with the NHCO3, then it gives a sodium salt of benzoic acid and it is your considered as the product D. Next I will do the question number 8. This is your phenol. It is subjected to reaction with zinc. Then zinc oxide will be removed. Then benzene will be formed. This is your said to be product A. Then benzene is subjected to reaction with C3Cl. In the presence of anhydrous AlCl3, that is your said to be Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Then alkyl benzene is formed. This is your said to be product B and it is subjected to oxidation in the presence of alkaline KMnO4 and heat must be given. Then benzoic acid is formed. This is your benzoic acid and it is considered as the product C. Now this is subjected to the reaction with the NH3. Also heat is given. Suppose heat will not given, then what will happen? Then ammonium salt of benzoic acid will be formed. Since heat is given, so it is bound to loss and water molecule from this salt. For water molecule, we need two hydrogen from this and one oxygen. That means it gives CONH2. That is said to be benzamide, and it is considered as the product D. Now I will do the question number 9. This is said to be benzoic acid. It is subjected to reaction with BCl5. Then acid chloride is formed. This is your acid chloride and it is considered as the product A. Again it is subjected to reaction with palladium barium sulfate. That is your also sulfur is given. Then ozone bond reduction takes place and benzaldehyde is formed. Then again it is subjected to reaction with the concentrated NaOH, CMD will be formed. This is your B product. B product is your benzaldehyde and it undergoes Kanigsbaum reaction. Then a salt of carboxylic acid is formed and an alcohol is also formed. That means here we can write this is your sodium benzoate and it is considered the product C, and this is considered the product D. Now I will do the question number 10. This is your benzaldehyde. It is subjected to oxidation. When benzaldehyde subjected to oxidation, then benzoic acid is formed. Now benzoic acid is subjected to reaction with the concentrated HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4. This is your said to be nitration. NO2 group will be attached at the meta position because COOH is a meta directing group. That means we can write this product. This is said to be A and this is said to be B. Now B is treated with sodium hydroxide in the presence of calcium oxide. This is said to be soda lime. Heat will be given. At first what will happen? This is your metanitrobenzoic acid. At first it reacts with the sodium hydroxide, gives a sodium salt of carboxylic acid. This is your NO2 present at the meta position. Now this product is subjected to reaction with the soda lime, NaOH in the presence of CaO. Then Na2CO3 will be removed like this, and here we can form nitrobenzene. Here H will be attached here, and already NO2 is present at the meta position. That means this is your product C. Now I will discuss about the question number 11. Here methyl benzene is given. That is said to be also toluene. Now it is subjected to reaction with the 2 molecule of chlorine in the presence of sunlight. That is your HNU. What happens? This is your methyl benzene. Now it is subjected to reaction with the chlorine. One HCl molecule will be removed at first. Then it gives this product. Again this product react with another molecule of chlorine. here also one molecule of HCl will be removed and it gives this product. Two chlorine atom will attach to the carbon atom. So we can write here this is your said to be product A. Now this A product will react with the aqueous NaOH. Aqueous NaOH take two molecule of NaOH. As a result, we can write like this. Here two chlorine atoms are present, so we can remove NaCl molecule. Here also we remove NaCl molecule and 2H will attach this carbon. That means it gives this product. We know that two or more OH cannot be attached to a carbon atom because it feels unstable. As a result, this product wants to stabilize by the help of double bond formation between this carbon atom and oxygen atom. And this bond will break, gives OH minus and this is OH plus. There is a loss of atom molecule. And finally, we get there is your benzaldehyde. This is your said to be benzaldehyde. This is your B product. Next, the B product is subjected to oxidation here. Your oxidation retain. The B product undergoes oxidation. Aldehyde undergoes oxidation gives carboxylic acid. So here benzoic acid is formed as the product C. Next, this benzoic acid is subjected to reaction with the ethyl alcohol in the presence of an acid H+. When benzoic acid is subjected to reaction with the ethyl alcohol, then ester will be formed. So we can write this. This is your said to be product D. This product react with two molecule of chlorine in the presence of sunlight, or you can write H nu. This A product will obtain. This A product again reaction with the aqueous NaOH, then benzaldehyde is formed. Benzaldehyde undergoes oxidation gives C product, that is your benzoic acid. When a benzoic acid is subjected to reaction with ethyl alcohol in the presence of H plus, then an ester is formed, that is said to be ethyl benzoate. Now I will do the question number 12. This is your benzaldehyde. It is subjected to oxidation, means benzoic acid is formed. This is your said to be A. Now this benzoic acid is subjected to reaction with the NH3 and heat mark will given here. Suppose this is subjected to reaction with the NH3, then ammonium salt of benzoic acid is formed. When it is subjected to heating, there is a loss of water molecule. Two hydrogen comes from this and one oxygen from this, and there is a loss of water molecule and benzamide is formed, that is your C6H5CONH2. But the question is written here also 8 mark is given, so we can write this directly. That means directly you can write the benzamide product. integer said to be B. Now the B is subjected to reaction with P2O5. P2O5 is a reacting reagent. There is loss of water molecule. For water molecule, we need two hydrogen and one oxygen. As a result, there is a triple bond will be found between the carbon and nitrogen. That is your CNOH. And this is considered as the product C. Now this product C is subjected to reaction with the lithium aluminum hydride. Your reduction takes place. That means we can give your H, another H, H. That means we can find out this CH2 NH2. That is considered as product D. Now I will do the question number 13. Methyl benzene is given. Now it is subjected to reaction with the chlorine in the presence of sunlight, that is your HCl. One hydrogen atom combined with one chlorine atom forms HCl as the byproduct, and this is your said to be the main product, and it is considered as the product A. Now the A product will combine with the aqueous KOH. Then what happens? HCl molecule will be removed and this OH atom attached to this carbon atom and form, this is your main product, and it is considered as the B product. Next, the B product is subjected to oxidation. We know that alcohol undergoes oxidation and at first gives aldehyde, then it gives the carboxylic acid. So this is your benzoic acid, which is considered as the product C. Now this benzoic acid is subjected to reaction with the C2H5OH H+. Then ester is formed. We know that carboxylic acid, when combined with alcohol in the presence of acid, then ester will form. This is your ester, and it is considered as the product D. The name of this compound is ethyl benzoate. Now I will solve the question number 14. CH3COOH is given. It is subjected to reaction with the SOCl2. A product will be obtained. We know that this is the structure of acetic acid and this is the structure of SOCl2. One molecule of HCl is removed as byproduct. Next, the other chlorine atom combined with this part from the acetyl chloride, and this oxygen atom combined SO to form the byproduct SO2. Your C3COCl is formed as the main product. And the byproduct are SO2 and another is your HCl. So here we can write A means your CH3COCl. Now the A product is subjected to react with the benzene in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. This is your triddle cap acylation. That means this reaction. In this reaction, one hydrogen atom from benzene will be removed, and this part, that is the acyl part, will be attached here and gives this product. This is your C2E. Product B. So we can write here this product, and it is considered as the B. Now the B product is subjected to reaction with HCl, H+ and Cl-. Cl- will attach here and O will carry the negative charge and this H plus will attach to the oxygen atom and form this product. This is your product C. Again, the C product will react with the HOH in the presence of H plus, HOH in the presence of H plus. We know that when cyanide group undergoes acid hydrolysis, then it is converted into COOH, that is a carboxylic group. So we can write this. This is your said to be D product. Next, I will do the question number 15. This is your toluene. It is subjected to reaction with the KMnO4, KOH, that is your heating. That is your oxidation with the alkaline KMnO4. So, here a potassium salt of carboxylic acid will be formed and it is considered as the product A. And this A product undergoes hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis, gives a benzoic acid. Here H and another is OH. I will break here and gives H, another OH. KOH is the byproduct. This is your considered the product B. Now B product is subjected to react with Cl2 in the presence of FeCl3. This is your said to be halogenation. This is your said to be a meta-directing group. So at meta position, chlorine atom will attach this position and it is your said to be product C. Now I will do question number 16. This is the ethyl benzene. It is subjected to react with the KMnO4 and KOH. It is also given, it is said to be oxidation with the alkaline KMnO4. Then potassium salt of carboxylic acid is formed and this is subjected to acid hydrolysis. Here HOH will be formed and byproduct KOH will be removed and the main product is your this. That is said to be benzoic acid. Now the benzoic acid is subjected to react with the bromine in the presence of FeBr3. Then halogenation takes place. Since this is your meta directing group, so at meta position bromine will be attached. This and again it is subjected to reaction with the ethyl alcohol in the presence of H+, it undergoes esterification. That means this product will be obtained. Metaposition bromine will be attached. This is your said to be product A. This is your said to be product B. This is your said to be product C. This is your said to be product D. That is all about your conversion related to the aromatic carboxylic acid.